chairs up here yet, if anyone wants to have a chair.
Elgin E. Johnson, 99, of La Harpe, Illinois, passed away Thursday, October 10th, 2024, at 2:27 p.m. at the Wesley Village of Macomb. She was born August 29th, 1925, in La Harpe, the daughter of Raymond and Mabel Allen George. On April 8th, 1951, she married Victor Johnson in Blandinsville, Illinois. He preceded her in death July 12, 1982. Elgin was a green thumb worker at the La Harpe Senior Center for 25 years. She also cleaned the La Harpe Carnegie Library for many years. She enjoyed gardening and was a member of the M&M Club in Blandinsville and the Friendship Club in La Harpe. She is survived by her daughter, Vicki Burford of La Harpe, two grandchildren, Brian and Michelle Burford of La Harpe, and Brianne and Matt Burr of La Harpe, and five great-grandchildren, Maddox and Jace Burr, Gavin Burford, and Evelyn and Siri Kupani. Elgin was preceded in death by her husband, Victor, one sister, Beverly George, and her parents. Let us pray. Lord, again, we thank you for the opportunity to remember Elgin. Help us to bring the good to the forefront of our minds and carry that with us as we leave her here today in your hands. And we'll give you the praise. In Jesus' name, amen. I first met Elgin in 2006 when she was only 80. One of the first pieces of advice she gave me was to shave off my beard. I did not. But she very often reminded me that she didn't like it. I was tempted to shave it off for the funeral today, but I didn't, because I want to pretend to hear her scold me again. Another time she called me as her pastor to replace landscape timbers that surrounded her flower garden. I told her I didn't take any woodworking classes in Bible college, but I would give it a try. When I got there, I found that it wasn't a square, but it was a hexagon. I again emphasized that I had never taken a woodshop class, but she says, "Ah, you'll figure it out." I did figure it out. I called Gary Schroeder. And he got me through it, and I managed to get it replaced to her satisfaction. But after that, the comments about my beard seemed to die down. I could go on and on about stories and things she's told me, and they would all ring true with all of you because she treated everybody the same. Most amazing thing about her was her tenacity. She was set in her ways, she knew what she wanted, and she knew how she wanted it done. I sat in her living room and had many talks with her as a pastor. I found she was also wise and prudent. I've been in ministry for 25 years, and in that time I've conducted hundreds of funerals, literally hundreds. And of those hundreds of funerals, only two people were older than Elgin. So before we get into the committal service, I thought I'd share some things about longevity from the Bible. Deuteronomy chapter 5, verse 33 says, "You shall walk in all the ways of the Lord your God, as he has commanded you, that you may live, and that it may go well with you, and that you may live long." Proverbs 10:27 says, "The fear of the Lord prolongs life." Proverbs 3, verses 1 through 4 say, "Do not forget my teaching, do not let your heart keep my, or but let your heart keep my commandments. For length of days and years of life and peace they will add to you." Jesus himself said in John 10:10 that he came that we might have life and have it more abundantly. Let's look at that word abundantly. The definition in the Greek is exceeding some number or measure or rank or need, over and above, more than is necessary, super added, exceedingly abundantly, supremely, something further, more, much more than all, more plainly superior, extraordinary, surpassing, uncommon, preeminent, superior, advantage, and more remarkable and excellent. To me, Elgin Johnson fit all of those descriptors and more. And now she's with her Lord, and her life's never going to end. Grace.
that saved a wretch like me.
Is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Jesus said these words in John chapter 14, Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place, I will come again to receive you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. Where I go, you know, and the way. You know. And Numbers chapter 6 says, May the Lord bless thee and keep thee. May the Lord make his face to shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, into the ground we commit these remains, but into your hands we commit the spirit of Elgin Johnson. In Jesus' name, amen. That concludes the service here today.